Insert a bottle into the entry zip of the dry suit. Push this bottle down the sleeve until it is a good fit in the cuff area. Take a tube of suit seal and put some into a plastic container, such as an aerosol cap. Refit the cap to keep the remaining contents fresh. Using the supplied applicator brush, apply a 1-inch wide strip of suit seal to the entire circumference of the dry suit cuff, up to the stitching. For demonstration purposes, we have used a Dive Master dry suit, which has a neoprene cuff. The dry suit system can also be fitted to manchette latex cuffs and warm cuff systems, sometimes known as cuff warmers. For warm cuff systems, you would apply the 1-inch band of suit seal 1-inch below the stitching of the cuff warmer. Apply 3 coats of suit seal. Allow the first coat to dry, which may take up to 45 minutes. You will notice that some of the first coat will have soaked into the suit fabric in places and will appear thicker and less soaked in other places. This is normal. When the first coat is dry, apply a second coat. Again, this may take up to 45 minutes to dry. Finally, apply a third and final coat and allow 24 hours for this to fully cure. Each dry glove system is supplied with 3 rings for sealing. The grey ring would be used on thicker cuff seals such as neoprene. The large red ring would be used on thinner cuff seals such as latex. The intermediate blue ring can be used if you feel that neither the red nor the grey ring offer a good fit. This gives you the flexibility to fine-tune the fit of the sealing rings to your specific dry suit. When you receive your dry glove system, the locking mechanism will have the large ring fitted. You may need to remove this ring depending on your type of dry suit. Turn the fastening ring anti-clockwise and remove the ring. To unlock the glove from the main body, place the locking mechanism at the top, as we have done here, and place your hand so that you can grip at 3 o'clock and 9 o'clock. Then turn the ring anti-clockwise, which will unlock the glove, which can then be disengaged from the body. For the next stage, put your arm into the sleeve of your dry suit. Using a piece of chalk, mark a line from the centre of the back of your hand, up the cuff, and past the sealant which you applied earlier. This provides a visual centerline for the next stage of fitting the dry glove system, so that the centerline can be aligned with the locking mechanism. For demonstration purposes, we are using a neoprene cuff, and we will be using the small grey sealing ring. The sealing ring has 2 edges, a tapered edge which faces the hand, and a stepped edge which faces inwards towards the arm. Firstly, take the fastening ring and place it over the cuff with the threads facing towards the hand. Next, take the sealing ring, noting the tapered edge and stepped edge, and place into the arm via the shoulder entry zip opening. Ensure the tapered edge faces the hand when inserted. When the sealing ring passes under the fastening ring, squeeze the sealing ring to allow it to pass through. Manipulate the sealing ring so that it is located underneath the ring of suit seal which was applied earlier. This may take a short time to manipulate into place so that it is fully underneath the suit seal. Remember that the tapered edge of the sealing ring needs to be facing outwards towards the hand. To fit the dry glove housing to your dry suit, line up the red locking button with the chalk centre line which you drew earlier. Press the sealing ring home into the body of the housing. Ensure the centre line mark is aligned with the red button at all times. Insert the locking ring into the threaded area of the housing and tighten for one or two turns of the locking ring. Look into the cuff housing and check that the suit seal, which was applied to the cuff earlier, is visible all the way round. Next, take the tightening tool and locate it into the locking ring. Tighten the locking ring by turning the tool clockwise until it is hand tight. Put your hand inside the housing to firmly hold the body and fully tighten the locking ring. As you look at the locking ring and the locking body, you will see that there is a small gap. This gap indicates that the sealing ring has sealed up against the neoprene. If there was no gap, this would mean that the sealing ring was too small and you would need to use the next size up sealing ring from the one used. When preparing for diving, you'll notice that the locking mechanism is on the top of the cuff and easily accessible. Ensure that the glove system is in the unlocked position. Put on your thermal glove liner and then put on your outer glove. You'll notice that there is an arrow on the top of the glove connector, which should line up with the centre of the locking mechanism red button. Firmly push the two components together. Grip the locking ring at 3:09 o'clock and turn clockwise. You will notice this slot aligns with the centre of the locking mechanism. Push the locking button down and the system is now locked and ready to dive. To release the gloves, firstly press the red button. Next, squeeze the locking ring at 3 and 9 o'clock and twist anti-clockwise. The glove will now very easily pop off.